Everybody, welcome back my channel Khmer History. Today's what's up everyone and everybody, for me I'm okay. So saying now I will come back, see you everyone and everybody again. So today I have the one video that I want to share to everyone and everybody. Yeah, this video that I want to share to everyone today, I'll talk about the Ros Serei Sothea biography, okay, and speaking this. Now before I reading this paragraph and I reading about the this biography or her, yes, her biography, Ros Serei Sothea. So I thank you so much everyone and everybody, lady and gentlemen, that take the time for watching and listening my video in my channel Khmer History, and especially share my video and subscribe my channel also. Just now I detail about Ros Serei Sothea biography. Please everyone and everybody, lady and gentlemen watching and listening, Ros Serei Sothea was the greatest Cambodian female singer that ever lived. She had a powerful and electrifying voice with a haunting bell-like quality that resonated in the ear and the soul. Sothea was a tiny woman, okay, tiny woman, standing only 5 feet tall, but boy, she had a voice like an amplifier, and she really needed a microphone during her extraordinary career. She performed thousands of the wonderful song in the almost every imaginable genre. Unfortunately, we know little of her life story except through the beautiful music that she left behind. The little that we know tell us that her life was filled with heartaches and that it ended in tragedy. Yeah. She was a victim like so many others during those years, but her golden voice lie on. Ros Serei Sothea, birth name was Ros Sothea. She was born in 1948 to a century family in a small village in the Bat Dambong. Like many poor Cambodians, Sothea had a childhood defined by hardship. While a count worry, it is generally agreed upon that the Sothea family could not afford to send her to school, and that she grew up not knowing how to treat of the right Khmer. In her teens, she and her family began to make a living by performing as a traditional peasant band. Sothea and her brother Serei sing, while the rest of her family plays the music. They perform daily through the small village of the Bat Dambong. And whilst they didn't earn a lot of money, and this occasionally struggle, the music did provide food for the family. Slowly, their reputation grew. Sothea's talent was obvious, and her brother was also quite popular. And audience were coming to see the family band. Apparently, the band had name, seen loose to history, but the people come to know them as Serei Sothea, naming of the band after its two future singers. At the same time that Serei Sothea was winning over people was touring through Bat Dambong province, the Cambodian music industry based in Phnom Penh was experiencing rapid growth and producing Cambodia's first real music star. When word got out to the village that music scene and singer were making real money in Phnom Penh, Serei and Sothea were encouraged to go to the big city to seek their fortune. They had nothing to lose, so Sothea and her brother made the move south to the capital city. They arrived in Phnom Penh with no connection, and they start performing for free during the spotlight night at the local club. After just their first night, the two were heard by one of the club to be their regular singer. The two of them continue to perform and get work at some of the other clubs around town, and Sothea quickly become a success. The little girl from the village not only had a marvelous voice, she was also very charming and vibrant. Her beautiful and irresistible resistible lust would put a smile on your face and give you ghost bump simultaneously. Her popularity grew across the capital, and she began to work as a solo act, attracting growing group. The popular female artists at the time were good, but Sothea was something different. She's captivate men and women when they heard her sing. Her voice could not only delight audience but also bring heavy hit here to her eye and sorrow to their soul. When she opened her mouth and sang her heart out, audience were breathless. With Sothea's immense talent, she had eclipsed her brother in the board fame and popularity. She decided to break out on her own, but to keep making music under the name Serei Sothea as a tribute to the brother. Around the same time, Serei Sothea's popularity sparked the attention of the Phnom Penh record producer. She officially changed her name and signed her first record contract. Soon her music could be heard on radio across to Cambodia. She had her first hit around 1967 with the song stung, killed. During the following year, from the late 1960 to the May 1970, Ros Serei Sothea produced some amazing music classic in many genres. She even starred in a few films. It was during this year the heyday of the Serei Sothea professional life that King Norodom Sihanouk gave her the little Prithini Somleng Mie. Yes, Prithini Somleng Mie, okay. The Golden Boy of the Royal Capital. It was the first time the king had given any singer such as honor. During this time, a new sound was emerging. Yes, emerging in the capital, led by the female singer Sensi Samut, the Ivis of the Cambodia. He and Serei Sothea developed a great professional relationship and would collaborate often. Is the reigning king and queen of the Cambodian pop music. The two worked with other Cambodian musicians of the time to create what today is the sometimes called Cambodian psychedelic rock and garage rock. Influenced by Western red and blue rock roll and music from Latin America that the Cambodians were hearing on US Armed Folk Radio during the Vietnam War. The new sound was truly unique, creating of the Phnom Penh music scene of the 60s and 70s. The new Cambodian rock music replaced and supplemented the instrument of the traditional Khmer music with the Western style rock and roll band. The hybrid music was a perfect fit for Sothea High. Clear voice when coupled with the band featuring permanent distortion, la den lit guitar, pumping organ, loud, driving drum, the result made for an interest, intense fun, something, or sometimes haunting sound, haunting sound. A characteristic of this new Cambodian rock and often contradictory relationship between a sing lyric and its music. Misery, sick lyric of the broken heart and the doom fed are wears out, or set to the exuberant party tune. The translation to the Ros Serei Sothea have you seen my love, read I drink until I get drunk, but I can't seem to get drunk. The sky is all black, love has wings to fly. Yeah, so she bail out this my stories and melancholy lyric with a voice that is about joyous on against greeting and uplifting. In the background, the band get the people moving with the funky, fun, and upbeat dance groove. With Sothea, Korea, and the Cambodian music scan were thriving, Sothea was not all at all happy in her personal life. During a Cambodian media interview in the late 1990, her living son mentioned that when his mother was alive, she constantly reminded him not to be a single like her because she been through so much bitterness. Okay. Thank you everyone and everybody that take the time for watching and listening this my video talk about the Ros Serei Sothea biography part 1. Thank you everyone. See you on Ros Serei Sothea biography part 2. Okay. Goodbye.